This is Pastor Richard, and you're watching Anchored in Christ, a vlog from St. Paul's Lutheran Church to know what we believe and why we believe it to be anchored in Christ's word for us. Now, this week, we are looking at Luke chapter 10, verses 25 and following. It is the story or parable of that Good Samaritan. Now, it is a very familiar parable. Many of us have heard it before. However, what we want to do with the purpose of this lesson is to understand that context that that parable is found within. So if you have your Bibles, turn to Luke chapter 10. We'll pull that up on the sheet here on the screen for you as well. And as we can see, before we jump into that parable, we see that there's a lawyer, and that lawyer, he stood up and he did what? He put him, that is Jesus, to the test. And he's put him to the test by asking this question, and we can see that question right there. Teacher, what shall I do to inherit eternal life? Now, before we get too far with that question or the rest of the context, we have to ask ourselves this question. Is this man asking a question in a gospel-oriented framework or a law-oriented framework? Now, the answer is this, is that he is very much asking this question from a law-oriented framework, asking what he must do in order to acquire or obtain this eternal life. The focus is on the lawyer aspiring, clinging to, or accomplishing something or contributing something in order to obtain this eternal life. Now, the point of this that we have to understand is there's nothing that we can think, say, or do that will result in us obtaining eternal life. Eternal life has to be a gift. It has to be actually precisely an inheritance, something that we receive. However, this man asks a law-oriented question. So as a result, we look at Jesus' response. What does Jesus respond? Jesus says to him over here, he said to him, what is written in the law? You see how Jesus answers a law question with a law answer by pointing the man back to the law? He says, how do you read it? And he answered, you shall love the Lord your God with all of your heart, all of your soul, and all of your strength, and with all of your mind, and your neighbor as yourself. And he said to him, you have answered correctly. So Jesus is affirming him. If you want to do something to obtain eternal life, you shall love the Lord your God with all of your heart and all of your soul and all of your strength and all of your mind, and to love your neighbor 100% as you love yourself. Jesus says, you've done well. You ask a law question. Here's a law answer. Now go and do likewise. Do this and you will live. However, we see here in the following verse, in verse 29, this man, this lawyer, desires to justify himself. Now, the reason why he's trying to justify himself is he's feeling convicted that he is not loving God and loving his neighbor with all of his heart and soul and strength and mind, so he is attempting to justify himself. You see, we have to keep in mind that when it comes to the law, there's only really two responses. On the one hand, we can hear God's law to love him perfectly and love our neighbor perfectly as well, and we can see that and hear that and say, you know what, I don't do it. God have mercy on me, the sinner. Therefore, I repent of my sins and I need to inherit eternal life accomplished by Christ himself. Or I can look at that and try to justify myself in order to rationalize in my mind that I'm doing something well enough in order to merit and earn and do eternal life. And that goes the way of justification, to try to justify yourself. And that is exactly what this man does. He tries to justify himself, rationalize a way that he is somehow meriting and doing things well enough to obtain eternal life. And so then as a result of that, as we know from the story, Jesus goes down that path of telling that story of the Good Samaritan. Now, there's a wonderful little quote here in the Lutheran Study Bible. If you haven't had a chance to check this out, these are Lutheran Study Bibles put out by Concordia Publishing House. And here's what the Lutheran Study Bible says. It's just remarkable. He says that the Bible study notes say this: Jesus tells the famous parable of the Good Samaritan to clarify that he expects his followers to do good to all people, which is indeed, that's what the law demands. It demands us and calls us to do good towards God and our neighbor, to love God perfectly and love our neighbor as ourselves, without a doubt. However, his concluding exhortation, Jesus's concluding exhortation says this, go and do likewise. And this reminds us just how far we are from the loving self-sacrificing behaviors that the Lord expects. When he says, go do likewise as that Good Samaritan, when we look at that Good Samaritan, we look at God's law, we realize man, I don't do it. I don't love God the way I ought to. I do not love my neighbor as I should, which then brings us to a conviction of sin, which then should bring us to the point where we need to hear the gospel, to hear the good news. And this study note hits that for us as well. And it says this, so it was that Jesus became the good shepherd for us. Isn't that great? That's great news. He laid down his life. He befriended us while we were yet sinners and while we were yet his enemies. He promises us full restoration and life everlasting. So as we hear this parable and we hear how we ought to be this good Samaritan, we realize that we're not. But in the process of hearing that, we can also hear, on the other hand, God's other word of gospel, which is Jesus was that good Samaritan to us, that he did everything for you and for me. So there you have it. Think about this with the questions that we ask. They're law-oriented questions. Jesus gives a law-oriented response. And then for the purpose of us realizing that the law brings us to the contrition of our sins, that we just can't do it, so that we can hear the gospel answer of the Good Samaritan of Jesus of what he did for us. Law and gospel. Law showing us our sin. The gospel showing us Jesus. Law giving us repentance. The gospel giving us faith. I hope that helps. And we'll catch you next time.